What's up, love doves? Coming at you from a Sunday night in the barrio. Spring is springing. Spring has, in many ways, sprung. When I walk, I do my kettlebell at the park, at Encanto Park, and I see the trees that have been dormant for the winter, and their little buds are starting to bud, and it has so much potential energy, so much beauty, so much natural power that's just emanating from the earth, from the goddess, through the leaves, through the branches, I should say. And it's just these little buds of potential energy. And we feel different in our bodies during the spring. I know I do. I have like a little spring in my step. And I jumped on the mic tonight to talk about a concept that it was inspired by a live stream. I just came up off an amazing live stream with the brother Deus Ex Machinist and my friend Mark Steves. Mark Steves does the My Family Thinks I'm Crazy podcast. And I asked him, it's an amazing podcast, you should definitely check it out, My Family Thinks I'm Crazy. And I asked him, like, are you optimistic about the future? Because the conversation started to get a little bit heavy in terms of just like when you start talking about all the challenges that we face as a people, you can start to feel a little bit doomer about it. And so I was just like, asked Mark, like, hey, do you feel optimistic? And he said that he does. And the reason why he does is that the optimism comes from within. Optimism isn't something that just happens to you. It is something that you generate. So that's why I wanted to call this tidbit the engine of optimism, because we are co-creators in this reality and we have the power to create optimistic circumstances. We can be optimistic in our own capabilities, our own talents, and our own potential. We can take an active approach to generating environments that are conducive to optimism. And sometimes we just have to generate it out of thin air, you know, because I have been going through the ups and downs big time. And when the downs hit, they want you to stay in the downs. Oh, sorry, my synthwave background got a little noisy there. When the downs hit, they kind of want to keep you in the down. That's the depression is a very insidious and clever adversary. And I find that when I start to succumb to depression, it's a lot of feelings of non-action and passivity. I start to feel as though these things just happen to me. And then you go through all the reasons, like, of the things that happened, why you're down, you know. And sometimes other people can disappoint you. Sometimes people that you've known for a long time, they can disappoint you. And when you're stuck in the downs, you can start to like point to these instances of when people disappoint you. But what gets missed there, and the power of this idea of an engine of optimism, is that this is not something that just happens to you. You are not just a passive victim or recipient of these setbacks in life. We can take an active role in turning things around and just honestly putting one foot in front of the other. For me, it always comes back to my creative outlet. And, you know, having the live stream today really helped to like pull me out of my funk and get me back into the creation, the role of creation. I am a creator. I like to make art because it gives purpose. So when we say like, are you optimistic or are you pessimistic? You know, maybe things go in phases. So you might have a phase where you feel a bit more pessimistic. But just remember that you have the engine within you to create that optimistic mentality, that glass half full mentality, focused on the potential especially. So like the buds serve as this magnificent reminder from the Great Spirit that we are just packed with potential and possibilities. And the day you stop growing and learning is the day you start dying. So we can continue to grow and learn and create new neural pathways and learn new skills and meet new amazing people. We can continue to do this until the day we do pass. And so this is just a energy audio tidbit reminder that you are the host of your own vibes. You get to dictate. You are a creator. We are co-creators in this dream that we call life. And the more of us can co-create from a sense of internal, inherent, embedded optimism, the better chance we have to face the very real challenges and obstacles and setbacks that stand before us. So let's come together. Let's create a vibration of collective optimism about the future, focused on the budding possibilities of our innate knowledge, wisdom, instinct, all the things that make us so resilient as human beings. We have that collectively and we have it individually. And that can be a reservoir from which you draw upon to generate optimism when you need to. And I believe in synchronicity. And the more you believe in synchronicity, the more synchronicities happen. So as you orient yourself, as you orient your inner self towards optimism, you will meet others who are orbiting the same vibe. And you will start to generate your own luck. You'll start to generate your own breakthroughs. And if we can get enough of this happening on a societal level, and we keep our morality and our values in the forefront always of being honest, good people who care about one another, we can really create a beautiful, sustainable, self-reliant, and fierce society. And I think that would be a beautiful thing. So I love you all. Thank you so much. I'm gonna release the live stream on the RSS feed as well. It went for 3 hours. So that's coming up as well. And stay tuned. I have a bunch of interviews planned. So I love you all. And thanks for being a part of the podcast. Be good to yourselves out there. And remember, you have the engine of optimism within you, friends. All right. Peace out.